हेलो
हेलो।
सर, टुडे यू सेंड द ईमेल फॉर गूगल क्लासरूम आल्सो ना?
या
सो इट वाज अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ कंफ्यूजन बिटवीन बोथ ऑफ द लिंक.
ओके ओके ओके। इट इज अ यू एक्सेप्टिंग, सो व्हेनेवर यू नो वी आर गिवन सम मटेरियल्स और समथिंग लाइक दैट, सो इट विल बी गिवन थ्रू गूगल क्लासरूम, दैट विल बी बेटर फॉर यू।
बट टिल नाउ यू वर सेंडिंग फॉरवर्डिंग थ्रू ईमेल ओनली.
Already email already given, you know, if I am given any assignment, any, you know, quiz, then it will be very much difficult. Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, so we can on Zoom also we can move to Google Classroom and submit the assignment or quiz also.
Yeah, I given in the last, you know, so that's why. And
just now I was opening Google Classroom, it was not getting connected to it.
Just join, ma'am. You have a Gmail. You have a Gmail ID, ma'am.
Yeah, I am having a Gmail ID.
Yeah, so there, I think there will not be any problem.
So I was opening through Gmail ID only and forward entering the
no,
password.
No, whatever the mail ID you are given over here, it is a Gmail ID or your college ID or you know.
No, it's a Gmail ID.
Gmail ID. So I think there will not be any problem. I will be checked, ma'am. If you text me your email ID, I will be checked whether any problem or not.
Sir, TAR, shall I write in chat?
Yeah. Ma'am, you are writing chat. I will be checking. Good evening to all.
So I have forwarded my email ID.
Okay, ma'am.
RanaAfreen82@gmail.com.
Okay, ma'am.
Sir, it is better if all the participants turn off their video, sir.
Yeah. No, you on. No issues.
No.
Ma'am. Everyone in a good condition, good health. Any problem?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
We all are fine.
Fine. What are the scenario in your, you know, in your state or something like that?
So it's a red zone.
Red zone. Everywhere in red zone. I am also in a red zone.
Yeah.
Be safe little bit. Someone is green zone, good. Green zone always better. You have any idea regarding the online classes? How your online classes is going on?
So we are presenting online on Zoom also. Zoom and Google Meet. Both.
Both.
Yeah.
Students are interested, ma'am.
Sir, students strength are very much.
Wow, that's good. But not everywhere. I talked to yesterday with IIT Kharagpur and IIT Dhanbad. Both the faculties are says that you know, students are not interested.
The first year students are at present are sincere, and third year, fourth year students are not so much sincere.
Sir, ma'am, that's why I'm telling about. What about the third year and fourth year?
Sir. More than 50%, 60% students.
That's a good, ma'am. That's a good participation. In IIT also not 50%. Yesterday, I talked to a particular faculty. I don't want to disclose his name. In IIT Kharagpur, he told me that out of 93 students, only 39 Google Classroom they are accepting. Rest are not accepting till, you know, 40, 45 days. That's the biggest problem. Not everywhere. Maybe in your college it's good. Maybe Brajesh sir, it's good.
Both are fine.
Yeah. I'm just given 1-3 minutes because someone is coming, so that's why. It's very difficult to, you know, after starting the class. What about the scenario of Coimbatore Institute of Engineering and Technology? Hello. Sir, if you are here with me.
Sir, I'm talking with me?
Yeah.
Yes, sir, then what? Pardon?
You are in Coimbatore, no? Coimbatore
Institute of... No, sir, I'm in Integral University, Lucknow.
Okay. Someone is, given a message, Coimbatore. If anyone is there from Coimbatore Institute of Technology, Tamil Nadu, so whatever the scenario of your college, you all are okay. Means the student are accepting those things. Sir, what about your college? Maybe not online. Mr. Guru Raj K, are you there, sir? If are you able to hear me, so what about the your college scenario, sir?
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir. Tell me.
Sir, this is Yaren. Hello?
Yes, sir. Tell me.
Sir, we are an autonomous institution, sir. It's a 20 years old college.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, your college is accredited college, sir.
Wow.
And we have a pleasant atmosphere in our college. Coimbatore Institute of Engineering and Technology, sir.
Okay.
Hello.
Yes, sir. It's audible.
Yes, sir. We got more funds from.
Maybe some internet issues.
So can you hear me now? I'm
good. Yeah, sir. Tell me.
It's saying coastal area, sir, which is Karavali zone, which is nearer to Arabian Sea.
Oh, wow.
And right now, apart from Corona, we were in red zone, and now we have been shifted to orange zone. And wow. Still.
That's good.
And one more thing is, apart from this, we have a lot of climatic distortions, disturbances. We have been having severe thunder, lightning, rains here. And because of that, maybe even this may be leading to dengue fever, malaria, so all those things in parallel with Corona. So that is the case. And one more thing is, unfortunately, already the classes have begun for us this Monday, that is 4th May. Classes have begun. Today I'm sitting at home because of the difficulties in traveling. We don't have buses, transport, etc. All those have been private vehicles, they travel. I stay in Udupi, so I had to travel for 45 minutes, say around 40 kilometers, and I don't have a vehicle. So right now I'm staying at home. Maybe from tomorrow onwards they're starting the bus, I may have to go to the college. So we I leave my hometown at around 7:30 in the morning, and I will be coming back at 6 p.m. in the evening. So I don't know how the classes will go from tomorrow onwards, because I'll be traveling. So at 4 I log in when I'm at college, and 4:30 the bus leaves there. 4:30 to 5:30.
No issue, sir. No issue. You, if you have a headphone, I will not ask any kind of questions. You just listen. Yeah. That's enough.
Yeah, carrying the laptop, earphone, headphones, everything.
Yeah, yeah, that's but mobile phone is sufficient, na? Mobile phone, and if you have a headphone, so no issues for that.
Yeah, almost.
And, one thing is that, sir, what about your college already started, sir?
Yes, sir. I mean, it's not for the kids. It's only for the staff.
Only for the staff.
Yeah,
but till now in Bengal, Jharkhand, whatever, I know that no college is started. Still in lockdown.
So we are in Karnataka and we are autonomous plus we are under VTU. So there is something called Visheshwara Technical University.
I know, sir.
Yeah. So that has taken approved permissions from the government and they have started taking the staff. 33% of teaching and non-teaching staff has to be there in the college. For students, I don't know. Maybe it's starting in, maybe it'll start in first week of June or July. We are not sure, but we staff must go. So all teaching and non-teaching.
big.
That's very horrible, sir. Because even if one non-teaching staff in NITTE carries that corona, is definitely going to spread it to the entire
mass. You cannot predict everyone, na? Because it's not possible for you. Because someone is maybe coming from, you know, they are going in a market or something like that. You may be the contact, you know, with the corona patients and all. So you cannot, you can, you know, safety. Your safety is first. That's I think required.
Definitely, we'll go with hand sanitizer, mask, everything. But gloves and all, I don't know. And I don't know, sir. We are in danger if that happens, the entire staff strength.
It's very difficult, sir. It's very difficult for you. And, you know, it's very problematic things. It is not possible, sir, online classes taking from the, you know, from your home and etc.
No, we are done with the classes. We have taken almost 15 to 18 classes. We have completed the portions.
Yeah.
Syllabus so is why, everything is done.
Why requirement to go to the college? For the faculty. Because faculty is basically for the, you know, for the taking the classes or nothing else. So what are the requirement if it is you are doing the same classes from the college itself also. You are doing the same classes in the in your home also. So what are the necessity to go to the colleges?
Some institute take administration task also from the faculties.
We are having problems with admissions also now. Everything is affected.
Admission is not possible, sir. I think no one is coming in your college in the present scenario. In the present scenario, I think no one will be coming in the college.
All colleges have reopened, sir, in Karnataka.
Wow. All colleges?
Yes, sir. Under VTU, we have to go.
So, ma'am, what are the, you know, social distancing and all?
From tomorrow, we don't know, sir, what is going to happen. We have to start. But I don't have problem because I drive my car, so I'll be alone, no problem as such.
But ma'am, not everyone have the car, na?
Yes, sir.
And whenever you enter into the college, you cannot say your you know your colleagues, your maybe your technical assistants, you know maybe your office staff that don't come in your in my room or you know don't come in that particular.
That's what, sir. When we go outside, we don't know what is going to happen.
Yeah, it's very difficult, ma'am. It's very difficult.
Hello.
Yeah, ma'am. Okay, let's start.
Yes, sir.
Sound net problem, I think, sir.
Yeah.
Last year we had been to that NMI.
Ma'am, not audible.
Yes, tell me, ma'am.
Ma'am, not audible.
Sir, coming to feedback for you. The classes are going awesome, sir.
Thank you.
Yes, sir. The topics are being understood.
If I have a little bit more time, so I think it will be best. But, you know, we have only 5 days time. So I'm just going, you know, faster.
Sir, are you following Ayla book?
No, sir. Now, I already teach 500, you know, 500 batches, more than that. So now I am not following anything. You can follow Ayla, you can follow the
Majidi. Microcontroller in Amtec.
Oh, wow. Very good.
So I can very easily follow you.
Wow. Thank you. That's good. It's good, ma'am. So let's start this program. I think you can share my two window. I have a two window in the name of electrical engineering, Dumka. So one is you can see it's my laptop, and another is another mobile phone, which is nothing but a connected with my copies. Whenever I teach my copy, you can see. So that's also is required. And next part, what are the this program? In this program is nothing but a 10 numbers of data which is copied from the external memory to internal memory. Just see that is nothing but a written over here. RAM starting from 30H from external RAM. Data are stored from the memory location 8050. So I want to copy the content of 8050 to 30H. Of 8050 to 30H, next 8051 to 31H, next 8052 to 32H, as so on up to 10 numbers. So 10 numbers I will be copied from 8050 to 30H, 8051 to 31H, as so on and so forth. So basically 10 numbers I will be copied. So how it will be done, sir? Only one registers we have, that is to store 8050. Only one registers we have which is store 8050, means a 16-bit address. Only one registers we have which is can be stored the 8050. The name of the register is DPTR. The DPTR is nothing but a which can be stored 8050. This is the number one. And the to store in a particular memory locations means you need that at the rate of. At the rate means only support R0 and R1. So you should be store 8050. Yes, 1 minute. Just I'm getting laser. 8050 stored into the DPTR. DPTR only one 16-bit register where you can store. So DPTR, it will be 8050. Next, in 30H will be stored R0 or R1. Either in R0 or R1. So 8050 content will be stored into the 30H. So, you pointed using DPTR 8050 and R1 or R0. By 30H. Say we are pointed R1 30H. And how many numbers? 10. 10 means 0A. So 0A will be stored any kind of register which are not used in the program. So maybe from if I am using for this R1, so you can use R0, you can use R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, R7. So you can use any kind of registers. I'm repeat once again. Say you are using this 30H for R1, so you can use for 10. That is how many numbers is there that will be stored, that can be stored in either R0, R2, R3, R4, R5, R6, R7, any registers. So let's we store it in a R5. So how it will be stored? Just move and has nothing else. 10 is nothing but a 0A. So I'm storing R5 0AH and I'm storing R1 30H. Sir, why I am storing the 0AH? Because always we are decrement the R5 by 1 and checking whether the R5 is 0 or not. If R5 is not equals to 0, then it will be, you know, the loop will be continue. Because if I given any kind of tasks, like for students that you count up to 10, see, he can count 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 10. But whenever, you know, for processor doesn't have this kind of facility. Always, you know, I am given a highest value from, if I am to count 10. So from 10, 9, 8, 7, 4, up to 0. This is also 10 count. So we are going in this process. So that is nothing but we are given R5, 0, 5, 8. So whenever we are, copy the data, and we are always decrement R5 by 1. So first, copy the content of 8050 into the accumulator first, then the copy the content of accumulator into the memory location which is located by R1. So first copy the content of 8050 into the accumulator. What will be the instructions? Sir, this is not an internal memory location. 8050 is an external memory location. So we are using MOVX instruction. MOVX instruction is nothing but with the help of MOVX instructions, we are using just like a MOVX A comma at the rate of DPTR. MOVX A comma at the rate of DPTR. What will be the functions? You know, the function is nothing but the content of 8050 will be copied into the accumulator. So in the next line, MOVX A comma at the rate of DPTR. All are move, but this is the X. Why, sir? Because, you know, it is a copy the external memory locations. That's why X, MOVX. Next, sir, what will be done? That is the move at the rate of R1 comma A. Move at the rate of R1 comma A. What does it mean? The content of accumulator will be copied into the, that particular memory locations. Just see, move at the rate of R1 comma A. So it will be nothing but the content of 8050 will be coming into the R1. The content of 8050 will be coming into the R1. So next, what will be done? Next is it's a very, very easy. That is, first, I am copy the content of 8050 into the 38 memory locations. Then I will be copy the content of 8051, then I will be copy the content of 8051 into the 31H memory locations. Then I will be copy the content of 8051 into the 31H memory locations. Sir, how it will be done? It will be done is a very simple. First, I am increasing these two, that is the DPTR and R1. So INC DPTR and INC R1. So next instruction, INC DPTR and INC R1. So increment both DPTR as well as R1. So I am going into the next memory location. So if I am repeat from these two line again, so then what will be happen? The content of 8051 will be copied into the 31H memory location. The content of 8051H memory locations will be copied into the 31H memory locations. That is the function. Next, sir. So I am doing the one complete operations. So R5 will be decremented by 1 and checking whether the R5 is 0 or not with the help of DJNZ instructions. So going into the next instruction, that is the DJNZ. DJNZ R5 comma back means decrement the R5. And checking whether the R5 is 0 or not. If R5 is not equals to 0, then jump to the particular memory location. So this loop repeated once again and once again and once again until R5 is 0. So from 8050 to 8059, the data will be copied from 30H to 39H. The total program will be done, and the last line of the program is always, it's nothing but we are given an infinite loop. It's called here is jump here. It will be, run this line once again and once again. Just like in 8085, there is a RET instruction. So over here is nothing but here is jump here. We have given the last line of the program. Next. So it will be understood, everyone. If you have any queries, you can ask. Okay. So going into the next. ORG is nothing but originating address. WordG is nothing but an originating address. We are always starting with a, originating address. We are starting always from the originating address. Originating address is nothing but a, you know, where, from where you are start. From where it is start, it is called originating address. So originating address always, you know, given in the first line of the program. Originating address is nothing but a 00008 from the any program, or you can, you know, doing any kind of subroutine, or lookup table, then you can originating in a different memory locations like ORG 300, ORG 500. We have some kind of programs, then we will discuss how originating is used. ORG is nothing but originating from where, that is nothing else. And equate. This equate is a, you know, special, a very important thing. Equate, just see, count equate 25. What does it mean? Count equate 25 means nothing but a, wherever I use the count, it will be used 25. Whenever we use count, it will be used 25. So move R3 comma count hash count means move R3 comma hash 25H. So count equate 25, where we are using the count, it will be nothing but a use 25, nothing else. So it's a very, very important, that is the equate. Equate is nothing but a count equate 25. Say move R3 comma hash count means R3 will be 25H. End is nothing but a end of any kind of lookup table, something like that. So next, just see, we have a different kind of annotations of given the data. Say I am starting a data, this is called lookup table or any kind of data table, you can say. So it is starting from ORG 500. So it is starting from ORG 500. So 500 will be stored 28. Sir, after 28, there is a nothing is mentioned, either H, nothing is mentioned. If it is a hexadecimal, it should be mentioned H. As it is not mentioned, so we are assuming it. So we are assuming it. It's nothing but a, it's nothing but a decimal. Decimal, 28 decimal means it will be in, you know, 1C in hexadecimal. It will be 1C in hexadecimal. So 28 is nothing but a 1C in hexadecimal. So next, sir, 00110101B. B stands for here the binary number. 28 as a, you know, where I am given is a decimal, but it will be stored automatically hexadecimal. I given in a decimal, but it will be stored automatically in hexadecimal. That is stored nothing but a 1C. So 500H, it will be 1C. And you know, it will be convert, then it will be 3, it will be 5. So 35H. So 35H will be stored in 502H. It will be stored in 502H. You can give.
ਇਹਦੀ ਵੀ ਹੈ ਨਿਯਮ ਆਦਾ ਸਨ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਕੀ ਜੀਣਾ ਪੋਣਾ ਹੀ ਅਸਾ ਦਫਤਰ ਤੋਂ ਘਰ ਬੈਠੀ ਕੰਮ ਦਾ ਕੰਮ ਚਲਾ ਦੇ ਉੱਥੇ ਜਾਓ ਗਲਤ ਕਰੋ
ਓਕੇ ਆਈ ਮਿਊਟ That is 39H. So 500 will be 28 means 1CH. 501 will be 35H. And 502 will be 39H. Here H is mentioned, mean it will be act as a hexadecimal number. Means it will be act as a hexadecimal number. Means it will be act as a hexadecimal number. Next, sir, ORG 510H. What are the functions of ORG 510H? 510 is nothing but a, it will be start another table. It will be start from 510H. And you know, with a double invited comma means it will be given as ASCII code. Corresponding data will be stored automatically. Corresponding hexa value will be automatically stored into that particular memory location. We are given like that in a ASCII. Whenever we are doing some kind of, you know, interfacing or some kind of project, then you can see how it will be done. So we are given like that with an invited comma. Next, sir, just see, these are the procedure how to write the program. It is very silly things. Move a comma has 20 means every one instruction should be written in a one line, something like that. And you know, whatever the, you know, level means like x, where is the jump, those in a given in the first column, something like that. So next we are coming into the time delay. It's a very important, we have a three time delay you know, program. This is one, this is two, and this is three. Three time delay program we have. So first of all, we are calculating what are the time delay is, you know, to execute this program. We have a three different program, program one, program two, and program three. First, I'm talking about the program one. You just listen, for this line, remember, only two things you required. This line is required one, and this line you required two. Two machine cycle is required. This is a required two. This is a required one. This is a required two. Sir, what are the value of, sir, first of all, in this instruction, there is a wrong. What is the wrong in these instructions? I am mentioning move R0, has FFH. It is not FFH. It should be zero FFH because it is starting with the F. So whatever it is, sir, the DJNZ R0, here, it is required for two machine cycle. So the value of R0 is nothing but a FF. What does it mean, FF? It's nothing but the value of R0 is nothing but a 255. Value of R0 is nothing but a FF means 255. So it will, this line will be repeated once again and once again until R0 is equal to 0. So these, how many times this line will be repeated? That is 255 times it will be repeated. 255 times this line will be repeated, so what it will be depend the value of R0. So R0 value is FF, that's why 255. If it will be value 200, then it will be 200 times. If the value is 100, then it will be 100 times. So how many machine cycle required for this line? For this line, it is required 255 into 2. 255 into 2 means 255 into 2 is nothing but a 510. And the next one is nothing but a move R0, has FF for 1. So for this program, you required, for this line you required 510, and for this line you required, one machine cycle. So total machine cycle is required 511. I'm repeat once again. For this line, you required one, but for, as you know, the value of R0 is nothing but a FF. So this line will be repeated FF times. So FF time means 255 into 2, that is 510. So 510 plus 1, that is 511. So 511 machine cycle is required to execute the above program, number 2 program. It's clear? So 511 machine cycle means, as you know, every machine cycle required 12 T state. So if you required to calculate the time, what are the time required to execute the above program? So machines, first you calculate the T state. So what will be the T state? T state is nothing but a 511 into 12. That is the T state. What are the time? 511 into 12 by FOSC. If crystal frequency is 12 megahertz, then it will be 511 microsecond. If it will be different, so your value will be also different. It will be depend upon the FOSC, that means frequency of oscillations, frequency of crystals. Next, sir, program number 2. In a program number 2, you are assuming that you don't have this line and that line. First, you are assuming that these two line, whatever I given a yellow mark, is not available. So what will be there? Only these two instructions is there. So for this line, for here, look, how many machine cycle is required? Is required for one time, it's required two, as the value of R1 is 200. So 200 into 2, it will be 400. And it's nothing but a required one. So 400 plus one, it's required for this program is required, for these two line is required, 401. But you see, the DJNZ, what are the function of DJNZ R0? First, decrement the value of R0. What are the value of R0? Value of R0 is nothing but a 255. Decrement by one. So it will be 254 at the beginning. Next, that it will be jumped in that particular locations. Here one, it will be jumped over here. That is the here one. And next, what are the values, sir? Move R1 comma has 200. Move R1 comma has 200. What are the functions of move R1 comma has 200, sir? It's nothing but, sir. Again, store the R1 is the 200. Again, this line will be, these instructions will be repeated 200 times. So decrement the value of R0 by 1, but this loop repeated 200 times. This line will be repeated 200 times. So to execute one time here one loop, how many machine cycle is required? For this is required 400, for this is required 1, for this is required 2. So it will be 40. How many machine cycle required for that is nothing but a 403 to require the one time this loop. Why, sir? It's required one. This line will be repeated 200 times. For one time, it's required two. So 200 times, it will be required four. So 400 plus one, 200 times, it's required 200 into two, that is a 400. It's required one. So one plus 400 plus two. So it will be 403. So how many times this loop will be repeated? Depend upon the value of R0. The value of R0 is nothing but a 255. So how this 255 stored into the R0? Because R0 is an 8-bit register, but you are given a 3-digit number. But you see, sir, we are not mentioning over here age. As we are not mentioning over here age, so it's nothing but the corresponding, you know, hexadecimal value, that is the FF. FF will be stored into the R0. FF will be stored into the R0. So basically, this loop will be repeated. This loop will be repeated 255 times. So basically, total loop to execute the total, you know, total this loop execute, you required another 403 into 255. This is the number of machine cycle required to execute this loop only. To execute this loop, you need 403 into 255. So how many machine cycles required to execute the above program? Sir, only one instruction is left. That is the first one. So total 403 into 255 plus 1. 403 into 255 plus 1. That is the nothing but execute the total program. So I'm coming into the second program, third program. In the third program, if I am talking about, then if I am eliminating this line and that line, then this program will be become the program number two. Then this program will be become the program number two. So to execute the first, this line means from this to that, how many machine cycle is required? How many machine cycle is required? For this line is required one. For this line is required, you know, 255 into two, that is 510, and it is required two. So one plus 510 plus two, it will be 513. It will be 513. It will be 513. It will be 513. So 513, it's required for one time. 513 is required for one time. Sir, next, as you know, it is a required one time 513. How many this loop will be repeated? That is the FF times. So into 255. So it will be required to execute this program. To execute this level, how much required? Is required 513 into 255 plus 1 plus 2. 513 into 255 plus 1 plus 2. Plus 1 for this line, plus 2 for this line. Plus 1 for this line, plus 2 for this line. I am repeat once again, to execute this loop, how many machine cycle is required? For this program, we are already calculating 513 into 255. Sir, why over here 403, I think, into 255, but over here 513 into 255. In this program, you just 3, over here is 200, but over here is FF. That's why. So 513 into 255 plus 1 for this line, plus 2 for this line. So we can say 513 into 255 plus 3. 513 into 255 plus 3, it is execute for one time. It's required for execute for one time. To execute how many times? The value of R0, that is the FF. Means nothing but a 513 into 255 plus 3 into 255. That is the, you know, total value. So if I am, if you are calculating, so 513 into 255 into 255 plus 3 into 255, that is the required to execute up to from this line to that line, up to this line to that line. So total program 513 into 255, just see my copy, I am mentioning total program 513, just see my copy, 513 into 255 plus 3. Plus 3. Why plus 3? Plus 3 for this line 1 and this line 2. Plus 3 into 255. Into 255 as the value of R0 is 255. Total program, that's why plus 1. This is the total program. So, sir, if time required to execute the above program, then time required to execute the above program, then into 12 by FOSC. Into 12 by FOSC. You know, that is the functions of the of this third program. So if you are calculating, then you will be get, you know, the near about you just calculate, it will be, say, if it will be assuming as a, if FOSC assuming as a 11.0592 megahertz, then I think it will be near about 36 seconds maybe. Then maybe it will be 36 seconds. So next, sir, anyone have any kind of queries for regarding that? So I'm going to the next. Sir, just see in this program, this is another, you know, just like a program number one, this program is nothing but I am given AA and 55. 55 and AA, I am given in a port 1. What will be happen? If I am given AA and 55 in port 1? You can see my copy. What is the value of 55? 55 is nothing but a 0101. So that is 55. See, if I am connecting with the LED, 5 LED, sorry, 8 LED in a port 1, so this LED may be off, so that will be on. So that will be off, that will be on. That will be off, that will be on. That will be off, that will be on, or reverse. That will be depend on how the LED is connected. So if you know, so it, it's clear that one after another LED will be on and one after another LED will be off. That is the, you know, 55. That's why I'm choosing a 55. If I'm complement this value, if I'm complement this value, just see my copy. Just see my copy. You know, if I'm complement this value, then it will be 10, 10, 10, 10. Means with respect to the previous one, it will be on, it will be off. 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 So, you know, as microcontroller working in a microsecond, but we are a human being, we cannot run in a microsecond. So, to see the sometime this LED will be glow, to see this sometime, to see this kind of LED will be glow, we are given a delay between these two. We are given a delay between these two. We are given a delay between these two. So how much delay? We are given a delay. Then we are calculating the time. What are the delay we are giving? So just see in this program. Here crystal frequency is 11.0592 megahertz. Okay. Next, sir, see move A comma has 55H. So accumulator will be 55H. Move P1 comma A. So what are the value of P1 comma A? Accumulator is 55H, so accumulator value will be coming into the port 1. Coming into the port 1 means one after another LED will be glow. One after another LED will be glow. Then A call delay. What are the functions of A call delay? Is nothing but a jump from this line to over here. It is just like a subroutine. A call delay means jump from this line to that line. The jump from this line to that line. If I'm using the pen, so it will be clear. I will be jump from this line to that line. I will be jump from this line to that line. Next, sir, what are the functions is run? Move R3, 200H. R3, 200H. What are the functions of R3, 200H? Is nothing but a, you just see R3, has 200H means R3 will be 200. Next, here DJNZ R3, here means this line repeated 200 times. This line will be repeated 200 times. So it's required one times is required two machine cycle. So 200 times is required 400 machine cycle. So 400 plus one. So 400 plus one. And for RET another one. So 402 you required, okay, to, you know, required to machine cycle to execute this delay program. And the from return, where it will be returned? It will be returned back from where it is called in the next line. That is the CPL. So it will be jump from this line to that line, and it will be returned into the CPLA. So what are the function of CPLA? Here CPLA is nothing but a S jump. Next, CPLA is nothing but a complement accumulator. So 55 will be becomes AAH, means just complement. Where, you know, if I'm talking about the, what are the LED is, you know, previously it's on, now it will be off. Now it will be off. Now it will be off. So one after another LED will be on, or one after another LED will be off. That is the function of this program. But what will be jump? S jump again. Again coming into over here means after complement the value, it will be coming into the port one. Again call delay, again jump into that. So what are the time is required? Just see the delay calculations over here. Move R3 has 200 means it is a one machine cycle, it is a two machine cycle, it is a one machine cycle. So this line we require 200 into two. So that is the 200 into two. For this line, we required one machine cycle. For the last line, we required one machine cycle. That is the 402 machine cycle is required, as you know, into 12 by 11.0592. If 12 by 11.02, if you are calculate, it will, you will be get 1.085. 12, why sir into 12? Because every machine cycle required 12 T state. That's why into 12. That's why into 12. And you know, in by 11 FOSC means by 1.085, that is nothing but a 1.085. That's why I multiplied by 1.085, and it will be get 436.17 microsecond. So we can from this program we can calculate the time similarly whatever time I'm calculating the previous. Everyone have any query? Anyone have any queries? So I can explain. Otherwise, I will be going to the next slide. Okay. Next slide. We are second program, just like a second program. Whatever I am given the three program, program one, program two, and program three. This is just like a second program. In a second program, I need some more delay. In a second program, I need some more delay. But how it will be possible? How it will be possible? That's why, move R2 comma has 200. First R2 I am given 200 value. Next R3 have 250 value. Next what will be the happening over here? In a previous program we are not given this kind of NOP. This kind of NOP as I am given, so it will be increased one and one. There is a two machine cycle. So for DJ and Z R3 here. This is nothing but a now it's required to execute one time DJNZ R3 here, one time here loop. Means one time here loop, you required four machine cycle, 1 plus 1 plus 2. You required 1 plus 1 plus 2, that is a 4. So you required four machine cycle to execute, one time here loop. For one time here loop, you required four machine cycle. So what are the value of R3? R3 value is 250. So 4 into 250, that is 1,000 machine cycle is required to execute the R3 loop. That is for here loop. To execute the here loop total program, as the value of R3 is 250. So 250 plus 4, that is 4 plus 250 is nothing but 1,000. 1,000 machine cycle is required to execute the here loop. Next set, DJ engine R2 again. As we are done in the program 2, so it's required 1,000, it's required 1, it's required 2. So 1 plus 1,000 plus 2, that is 1,003 for one time. 1,003 is nothing but for one time. From where to where? If I am talking about, from this line to that line, I'm highlighting this one. Up to these portions, for one time, it's required. For one time, it's required for the over here, it's required. It's required one for this NOP and DJ engine R3 here, it's required 1,000 and it's required 2. So 1 plus 1,000 plus 2, that is nothing but a 1,003. That is nothing but a 1,003. So 1,003 machine cycle is required to execute this program. So next, sir, to execute the total program, how it will be possible? So it is 1 plus 1,003 into 200 to first execute the total program of again loop. Total program of again loop, how much? What are the value of R2? R2 value is 200. So it is 1 plus 1,000 plus 2, 1,003 into 200. So total to execute again loop, 1,003 into 200. So to execute the total program, 1,003 into 200 plus 1 for this and plus 1 for that. So this is nothing but the total execution, whatever I discuss. I'm again discussing for sir NOP and DJNZ. This line is required 1 plus 1 plus 2. So for one time it is required four machine cycle. As the value of R3 is 250. So 4 into 250 for this loop is required 1,000. It's required 1. It's required 1,000. It's required 2. So 1 plus 1,000 plus 2, that is 1,003. Next, sir, 1,003. So next it will be, sir, 1,003. What are the value of R2? R2 value is 200. So this loop will be repeated 200 times. Again, loop will be repeated 200 times. So 1,003 into 200. 1,003 into 200. It will be the value. 1,003 into 200. And then next, what are the total program? For this line, it will be 1. For that line, it will be 1. So 1003 into 200 plus 2. It will be total machine cycle. You know, total machine cycle is required. So execute the above program. What are the time required? As already mentioned over here, one machine cycle is required. 1.085. 1.085 means its crystal frequency will be 11.0592 megahertz, as we had discussed in the previous program. So as we are already calculated the number of machine cycle required, that is 103 into 200.
From the input keyword.
Huh?
Go ahead.
Now, 103 into 200 plus one, that is 103 into 200 plus 2 into 1.085. That is the total time is required to execute the above program. Sir, this is the another program where nothing but we are using a lookup table. We are getting a square of a number. Means I am given a port P1. We are given any input. We are given an input into the P1 and we are getting an output into the P2. So P1 we are given the X and P2 will be get X square. How we will be get X square? That's why we are write a table, lookup table. If you see this, how this number will be coming, just assuming 0 means 0 square, 1 means 1 square, 2 means 4 means 2 square, 9 means 3, 4 means 16 means 4 square, 25 means 5 square, next 6, 36 is 6 square, and so on and so forth. So we are given this value in a, after that any D or H or anything is mentioned, or B is mentioned, is nothing is mentioned, so that will be in a decimal. Corresponding hexadecimal automatically will be stored. From where it will be stored? It will be stored, it is the from 300H. So 300H, it will be stored 00H. Up to this, there will be no change. So 300H, because up to 9, decimal and hexadecimal basically the same. So 300, it will be 00H. 301, it will be 01H. 302, it will be 04H. 303, it will be 09H. Next 16. 16 is nothing but if you are converting to the hexadecimal, from decimal to hexadecimal, it will be get 10H. So 304, it will be 10H. 25H, if you are converting to the hexadecimal, you will be get 19H. So 305 will be 19H. 306 will be 24H, corresponding 49 corresponding hexadecimal. 307, you will be get 64 corresponding, value of 49 corresponding value of the decimal. 49, you can subtract 48 means 16 into 3, that is the 3, and remainder 1. So 31 will be the number. So 31 will be put it, and the next, that is a 308, that is a 64. 64 is nothing but a 40, and for 81 is nothing but a 51. These are the hex value which will be automatically stored into the particular memory locations. So next questions, how this program will be operate. First I am explain this table, how this table it will be act. It's called a lookup table, or a data table, where you can, from this table you can see and you can store the result into the port 2. So first, say if we are talking about we are measuring the temperature of a room temperature for your mini project or micro project, you are doing this basically the same kind of project, because sensor never you give the corresponding temperature. Sensor given in a voltage, so corresponding voltage equal to your temperature, that should be a table. Whatever the value you are received, if you are talking about the hexadecimal number system, so 002FF you are receiving from your sensor end means sensor may be given any kind of millivolt range or any kind of volt, but But you know, any kind of millivolt or any kind of volt corresponding hexadecimal value will be received into the microcontroller. And you know, this hexadecimal value, it will be stored in a several memory locations, and the corresponding temperature it will be stored over here. Like say 304H is nothing but a square of 4. 305H is nothing but a square of 5. 306H square of 6, 307H square of 7, 308 square of 8, 309 square of 9, 300 means square of 0, 301 square of 1, 302 square of 2, 303 last num square of 3. Store this kind of value. So how this program will be, you know, execute? Remember, by default, our four ports, that is a port 0, port 1, port 2, port 3, all are used as a output port. All are used as an output port. But whenever you required to use this port as an input port, initially you are given a FF. You are given a high value. That's why I am given a high value. First, I am pointing this 300H with a DPTR. Move DPTR comma has 300H. Move DPTR comma has 300H. This is nothing but a program. So remember, this table also written in program memory. Means it's written in a code memory. Never in, you know, it will be not stored in any kind of memory locations. So for code memory, we have the instructions like move C. So remember, you know, move C instruction will be used over here. So move DPTR comma has 300. So DPTR will be 300. Next, move A comma has 0 FFH. After the instruction accumulator will be FF. So move P1 comma A. What are the functions of move P1 comma A? Accumulator, you know, the content of accumulator, that is the FF, will be stored into the P1. So P1 will be nothing but a content of accumulator. Content of accumulator is nothing but a FFH. Next, sir, move A comma P1. What are the functions of A comma P1? Sir, what are the value of P1? Value of P1 is nothing but a, you are given any kind of input. Whenever after these two instructions, P1 act as a input. Configure port 1 as an input port. Next, sir, whenever you are using move A comma P1, means say you are pressing any kind of switch. Switch means, just see my copy, you will be able to understand. P1 means P1.0 to P1.1, as so on, P1.7. These are the 8 lines is there, right? So every line there will be a switch. So this terminal connected with a ground. This terminal, say, given a 10k resistance or any kind of resistance, maybe 20k resistance, 10k resistance, given with a plus 5 volt, So whenever you press the switch, it will be connected with the ground. Whenever we press the, you know, push button switch, this will be connected with the ground. As connected with the ground means corresponding 0 and 1, you will be get through port 1. So port 1, you have a keyboard or you have a, you can connect in a different 8 switch. You can create your own. So with the help of that, say you are given a 03. In port 1. It will be given in port 1. And it will be coming into the accumulator through port 1. As you see, move A comma P1.
So accumulator will be 03 after this instruction, whatever you given a switch. Say we are phase 3, so I am getting 3 over here. So next, what are the value of DPTR? DPTR value is 300. What are the value of A? A value is nothing but A. Now you are given 3. So 3 plus 300. What will be the value? 303. 303. What are the value of 303? That is a 9. So these 9 are coming over here in an accumulator. So accumulator will be nothing but a 9. Accumulator will be 9. So move P2, A. What are the functions of move P2, A? Here nothing but a, the content of accumulator will be copied into the port 2. Content of accumulator will be copied into the port 2. Means 303 memory locations content has already copied into the accumulator. So accumulator is 09. So 09 will be transferred into the port 2. The 09 will be transferred into the port 2. So you can see, you know, if you are connecting the 8 LED with the port 2, you can see that is the 09 will be displayed. So if again, S jump back. So again, coming into that line, you are pressing, you know, switch 5, you know, given a 5. So if you are pressing the 5, so accumulator will be get 5. So DPTR value, it is a 300 plus 5. So it will be 305. What are the content of 305? That is 19. 19 coming over is an accumulator and it will be passes through port 2. So port 2 will be 19. As a result, whatever the value you are given, corresponding square, you will be get it in the port 2. Any queries if you have? Otherwise, we will be enter into the SFR register. We will be enter into the very interesting chapter, that is the SFR register. Now we are entering into the TMOD and TCON. So I am, go ahead. Next we are entering into the, you know, timer oblique counter. What are the functions of timer oblique counter? It's nothing but a, it's timer is nothing but a, I already told, is timer and counter always used for, you know, generate the clock delay, nothing else. Timer, which is count the internal clock pulses, and counter is nothing but a count the external clock pulses. That is the function of timer and counter. That is the function of timer and counter. So first we are talking about the TMOD register. So we are talking about the TMOD register. So what are the functions of TMOD register? So just see, we have this kind of, you know, TMOD register. This is a TMOD registers. TMOD register, before TMOD register, this is a timer 0 register. Timer 0 register is nothing but a TI0 and TL0. Together is called timer 0. Together is called timer 0, TI0 and TL0. TI0 is nothing but a higher 8 bit. TL0 is nothing but a lower 8 bit. Similarly, timer 1 also. Similarly, timer 1 also. Next, get C/T bar M1 and M0. Get C/T bar, there is a bar, and M1 and M0. What are the function? These four, get C/T bar, M1 and M0, and this is nothing but a get C/T bar, M1 and M0. These four are used for timer 1. These four are used for timer 0. So D0 to D3, these portions is nothing but a used for timer 0. And these portions is used for timer 1. So I am just, you know, you can see my copy. If you want to see, you can see just my copy. I'm just mentioning. So this is nothing but a get. This is nothing but a C/T bar. This is nothing but a M1. This is nothing but a M0, same, get C/T bar, M1 and M0. These four is for timer 0. These four is used for timer 1. So first four is for timer zero, and second four is nothing but for timer one, as we have a two timer. There's some beat we cannot set, some beat we can set. Some beat we cannot set, that will be set by the hardware, and some beat set or reset by us. So get pin is not set by the us. Get pin not set by the us. It will be set by the hardware. Get pin is not set by the us. It will be set by the hardware, either in for timer zero and or for timer one. Means either, you know, in slide, this gate and this gate are not set by the us. It will be set by the hardware. You know, whenever the TRX bit we are set, whenever we are set the TRX bit, TRX means it will be either TR0 or TR1. If we are set TR1, then this get pin mean timer one get pin. You just see my copy. If we are set the TR1, corresponding timer one get pin will be set. If we are set the TR0, corresponding, you know, get pin will be set. Obviously, that will be depend upon the several function, that is INTX or something like that, if there is no interrupt and all. But you know, TR1 and TR0 is used for set the gate. What is the function of gate? Gate is nothing but after set this gate, corresponding timer will be start for counting the clock pulses. Before, it's not possible. Next, C/T bar. What are the functions of C/T bar? As we know, bar means active in low signal. Bar means active in low signal. C/T bar means counter operations / timer operations. Counter operations / timer operations. You just see there is a bar. Bar means active in low signal. Active in low signal, and C is nothing but a counter operation. C is nothing but a counter operations, and T is nothing but a timer operations. So whenever it will be zero, it is set by the us. Whenever it will be zero, timer operations will be performed. Whenever it will be one, then counter operations will be performed. So, you know, if C/T bar is equal to zero, then timer operation. If C/T bar is equal to one, that is the counter operation. This is set by the software, or this is set by the us, whatever you can see. Means programmer can set this kind of bit. Next, M1 and M0. What are the functions of M1 and M0? You can see that several mode is selected. That is the 000 is nothing but a 13-bit timer mode. That is a 13-bit timer mode. In 13-bit timer mode, 00, that is mode 0. In mode 0, it's called 13-bit timer mode. Remember, it's called 13-bit timer mode. It can count 0000 to FF1F. 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 Next, my second question, next, another thing is that here 8-bit for THX and 5-bit for TLX. Sir, what are the functions? 8-bit THX and 5-bit TLX? Remember, it's very, very important things. You know, we had already, if you want see the slide, you see the timer 0 register is nothing but a TH0 and TL0. Similarly, timer 1 is nothing but a TH1 and TL1. THX, basically, THX is nothing but a TH0 and TH1 together is called THX. TH0 and TH1 together called THX. Similarly, TLX is nothing but a TL0 and TL1. together is called nothing but a TL0 and TL1. Together is called TLX. Together is called TLX. So basically, TLX and THX is nothing but a, we are using over here 8 bit for THX, 5 bit for TLX. THX is nothing but a TH0 and TH1, whatever it is. Maybe for timer 0, it will be TH0, timer 1, it will be TH1. For TLX, it will be TL0, TL0 for timer 0. TL0, it's for timer 0. And TL1, it's for timer 1. That is nothing but a, you know, the functions of mode 0. That is the 13-bit timer mode. It can count 0000 to FF1F. Next, sir, 01. Sir, 01. 01 is nothing but a mode 1. 01 is nothing but a mode 1. 01 is nothing but a mode 1. Sir, what are the functions of mode 1? Mode 1 is nothing but a 16-bit timer mode. Mode 1 is nothing but a 16-bit timer mode. Mode 1 is nothing but a 16-bit timer mode. What are the 16-bit timer mode? 16-bit timer mode, it's a mode 1 and it's a 16-bit. It's a 16-bit. 16-bit means it can count 0000 H to FFFFH. 0000H to FFFFH. Here, 8-bit for THX and 8-bit for TLX. 8-bit for THX and 8-bit for TLX. That is the functions of, you know, T-mod. That is the type, sorry, mode 1. That is the 01 mode 1, right? Next, we have say it can count, sir, 0000 to FFFF. It is a long count, sir. Long count means it is a long delay. It is a long delay also. So if you want to reduce the delay, if you will reduce the delay, how it will be done? In childhood, you know, there is a game, you know, we are going here and there. Someone is, you know, counting 0 to 100, something like that. So, if, you know, I'm talking about, say, my speed is high with respect to others. So, say, I'm just counting like that. 0 to 100. So, you will be say, sir, you are not counting 100. Or if I'm counting like that, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I count 100. So you will be say, sir, now you are not counting 100. You are counting up to 10. So that's why, sir, I'm just telling about whenever you know you are doing this kind of game, if you are starting the value from 80, you are starting the value of 80 and you counting up to 100, no one can raise the questions. Like 80, 81, 82, 83, 85, 100. So if anyone is saying that you are not counting 100, yes, I counting the 100. If you are starting in a slower, you know, it is not audible like that. If the 80, 81 is a very thin, then no one can understood. So if your initial value will be higher, then delay will be reduced. If your initial value will be higher, then delay will be reduced. In this mode, In this mode, you have the value like, 0000 to FFFF. Say you are given the initial value like that, ABCD. You are given the initial value like that, ABCD. So it will be counting from ABCD to FFFF. So, you know, to counting 0000 to FFFF and counting ABCD to FFFF. So it is a less delay with respect to the first one. it is a less delay with respect to the first one. So basically, whenever you required to reduce the delay, we will be given the initial value will be the higher. We are given the initial value to the higher, means initial value will be given, you know, instead of 0000H, we are given initial value is ABCDH. So ABCDH to FFFF, counting is less. So this mode is nothing but whenever you require to smaller delay, you will be increased your initial value. You will be increased your initial value, right? To increase your initial value, what will be you done? You can store any kind of value if you require smaller delay. So you will be increased this ABCD. You will require higher delay. You will be decreased ABCD, something like that. It will be depend upon you. But remember, this mode 0 and mode 2, whenever you are coming in the next program, you are always given, you nothing but the initial value. You are always given the initial value. What are the initial value? Initial value is nothing but a, you know, what are the you are given, that is a ABCD. If you are execute the program again, then again also it is ABCD you are given once time. So ABCD given, how many times you are running the program, you always given the initial value. Mode 2 is a very important mode, that is the 10. That is the 10. It's called mode 2. It's called auto reload mode. It's called auto reload mode, 8-bit. Obviously, it's 8-bit. It's 8-bit auto reload mode. 8-bit auto reload mode. What are the functions of 8-bit auto reload mode? Sir, it can count. It can count as 8-bit 002FF. 002FF, it can count. It can count 002FF. Next, sir, here THX. THX used for initial value store. Used for initial value store. And TLX used for counting the value. Used for counting the value. So THX used for store the initial value, and you know, TLX used for counting the value. Sir, what are the functions of, you know, THX and TLX? THX is used over here for storing the initial value, and TLX is used for the counting the value. Means, what are the functions, sir? I'll repeat once again. Say, in the first program, you are given the initial value. You can count from 002FF. 002FF. So you required a smaller delay. You are given the initial value like that, AB. So it will be count from AB to FF. So after FF, you know, in the previous program, all the program, after FF, it's become 00H. Either in, you know, in mode 2, either in mode 0 and mode 1, both the cases, after, you know, in if I'm talking about the mode 1, after FF, it becomes 0000H. After, you know, mode 0, after FF1F, it becomes 0000H. But remember, in mode 2, after FF, it will not be become 00H. It will be stored the initial value again. Means after FF, it will be automatically stored the initial value which is given in the program previously. That is the AB. That's why here THX is used for the initial value and TLX is used for the counting the value. It's a very, very important thing and a very, very important mode. Not required always store the, you know, initial value once again. It will be stored automatically. And number four, that is the 1-1, that is the mode 3. It is a split timer mode. It's the 8-bit split timer mode. Whereas TL0 is used for timer 0. And TH0 is used for timer 1. Yeah, TL0 is used for timer 0 and TH0 used for timer 1. Here TH1 and TL1 is not used. So it's a very, very important mode, these four. I'll be coming with a program, so you will be able to understand in details. Next. Any kind of queries regarding that? 13-bit timer mode, 16-bit timer mode, 8-bit auto reload mode. So I'm going into the next. Next, sir, just see, this is a diagram, nothing else. You know, when the C/T var is equal to 0, then timer operation, then it will be count the internal clock pulse. When C/T bar will be 1, then counter operation, it will be connected with this pin. Pin number 3.4, you just see pin number 3.4 means P3.4 is nothing but a T0. T0 means timer 0. As it is talking about the timer 0, so external clock pulse is counting by the counter operations or timer. When get pin is 1, it's mandatory. This is the TCON register. Its name is timer control register. You know, C/T bar, I already mentioned the functions of C/T bar. This is a diagram of C/T bar functions. So C/T bar is 0 when it will be count the internal clock pulses. It is coming from the, you know, internal crystals. And whenever, you know, it will be C/T bar is equal to 1, it will be connected with that, means it will be clock pulse which is coming from the pin number port 3.4. Port 3.4 is nothing but a T0. If you see the, you know, the pin configuration whenever I'm discussing in the first class, that is the T0 clock pulse is nothing but a enter into the microcontroller, and it will be count, it will be count by the timer or counter 0. It will be count by the timer or counter 0, obviously when get pin is equal to 1. Otherwise, its counting is not possible. Next, it's TCON. TCON is nothing but a timer control. TCON is nothing but a timer control. So TFX, I'm talking about the TF1 and TF0. Together, I'm telling about TFX. TF1 and TF0. Together, I'm talking about, you know, nothing but telling about the TFX. TFX is called nothing but a timer X. Timer X overflow flag. Timer X overflow flag. Timer X overflow flag. It's said by the hardware, but clear by the software. It's said by the hardware, but clear by the software. Remember, it's said by the hardware, but clear by the software. Means it will be set automatically, but clear by us. It's set by, it's automatically, but it's clear by us. So now question is coming that when it will be set. Means when it will be set. Say, sir, it will be set like that. Say in a mode one. What will be the mode one? Mode one is a 16-bit timer mode. So mode one is nothing but a counting from 00 to FF any value. So last count, you just see my copy. Last count. Last count is nothing but a FFFF. So after FFF, it becomes 00000H. It will be in mode 1. It will be in mode 1. So if I'm talking about the mode 0, then it will be after FF1F, it will be 00000H. Then it will be set. In that time interval, corresponding TF flag will be set. Corresponding TF flag. Sir, why corresponding TF flag? Because if you are working with a timer 1, then if you are working with a timer 1, then TF1 will be set. If you are working with a timer 0, then TF0 will be set. I'm telling about once again, if you are talking about, you know, that timer 1 is nothing but a TF1 flag will be set. and timer 0 is nothing but a TF 0 flag will be set. So every time, see, I'm talking about the mode 0, then after FFFF it becomes 0000H. After FFFF it becomes 0000H. Means after FF, whenever it will be becomes 0000H, corresponding TF flag will be automatically saved. Means corresponding TF flag will be automatically saved. And corresponding means if I am working with a timer 1, then TF1 will be flag set. If I am working with a timer 0, then TF0 flag will be set. Next, I am talking about the TRX. Remember, TF flag is set by the hardware, means automatically set, but clear by us. So whenever we write the program, it should be in your mind. Whenever we write a program, we always clear the TF0 flag or TF1 flag, whenever we are using. Next, sir, TRX. That is the TR1 and TR0. TR1 and TR0. TR1 and TR0, what are the functions? It's called timer X run control bit. Timer X run control bit means TRX. Together is called TRX. Timer X run control bit. What are the functions of timer X run control bit? Means after set this bit, it is set and clear by us. Means set and clear by the software. So whenever you know after set or clear by the software or user, corresponding timer will be on for counting the clock pulses. After set TRX bit, corresponding timer will be automatically on for counting the clock pulses. For counting the clock pulses means I am given initial value, everything I am given. I have set the value of TMOD. But until I set the TR0 or TR1, then TR0 is for timer 0, TR1 is for timer 1. Timer 0 or timer 1 will not be start for counting. After set this bit, corresponding timer will be start for counting the clock pulses. And you know, if you want to stop the counting, if you want to pause the counting, then it should be 0. It should be 0. Next, IEX, IE1 and IE0. These two bit, IE1 and IE0, these two bit is nothing but a, you know, we are called external interrupt X flag. External interrupt X flag. It's called nothing but a external interrupt X flag. What are the functions of IEX? IEX is nothing but a external interrupt X flag. External interrupt X means maybe external interrupt 0, maybe external interrupt 1. When any interrupt is recognized or interrupt is generated from the external world, then it will be corresponding these IE1 and IE0 automatically set. And IT1 and IT0, it's a very important, another important thing is that IT1 is for interrupt 1, means IT1 for external, just see my copy. IT1. IT1 is nothing for internal interrupt 1. It's for interrupt 1, and IT0, it's for interrupt 0, right? So basically, what are the functions? Sir, this kind of clock are enter into the, you know, microcontroller, any kind of clock is coming. So when interrupt will be generated, it depend upon the ITX. ITX means it may be IT0, it may be IT1. If ITX is equal to 0, then it's called low level. Means interrupt will be generated in low level. Interrupt will be generated in low level. If ITX is equal to 1, then the interrupt will be generated in falling edge. So interrupt may be generated in a low level or falling edge. That will be depend upon the ITX, means either IT1 or IT0. It will be depend upon the external interrupt 0 or external interrupt 1. If 0, then you know, it's called you know low level. If 1, then if 0, then it's called low level. If 0, then it's called low level. If 1, then it's called is nothing but a falling edge. You just see ITX control state and clear by the software to specify the falling edge or low level. Means set, then falling edge, clear, then low level. We are enter into the program. Sir, just see, this is a mode 0, 13-bit timer oblique counter. Mode 0, 13-bit timer oblique counter. We are assuming C oblique T bar is equal to 0. Means it will be count the internal clock pulses. Clock pulses are coming into the microcontroller and you know it's counting. So here THX is for 8-bit and TLX for 5-bit, whatever I discussed. THX is 8-bit and TLX for 5-bit. 8 plus 5, that is a 13-bit. It's a 13-bit timer mode. So it can count from, you know, 0000 to FF1F. So after FF1F, it becomes 0. In that particular time interval, corresponding TF bit will be automatically set. Corresponding TF bit will be automatically set. Means after FF1F, it becomes 0. In that particular time interval, corresponding TF bits will be automatically set. This is a 16-bit timer mode. Means it can count 00 to FFFF. After FFFF, it becomes 0. Means after, you know, when FFFF to 0, then corresponding TF flag will be automatically set. This is nothing but a 16-bit timer mode. This is nothing but a 13-bit timer mode. All the cases, if I'm assuming that this is a timer operation, C oblique T bar is equal to 0. So counting the internal clock path. Next, sir. And this is the first program, you know, for timer. It is, I mean, mode 1. Mode 1 means 60, you know, mode 1 is nothing but a 16-bit timer mode. Mode 1 is nothing but a 16-bit timer mode. So just see the program. In this program, it's required that 50% duty cycle. 50% duty cycle means T on and T off should be equal. Means you know. If I'm talking about you need a square wave, it new a square wave on pin P1.5 means how much time your T on, it should be equal time of T off. How much time your T on and it should be equal to T off. So move T mode comma has 01H. Sir, which timer is anything is saying? Nothing is saying that, but what saying is, you know, timer 0 is used to generate the time delay. So we are using the timer 0, number 1, and which mode? Mode 1. Timer 0, mode 1. If you recall the T mode register, if you recall the TMOD register, what will be the value, sir? Get pin. Get pin is nothing but a, sir, it should be 0. It's not set by us. Sir, which timer is used? First, C, timer 0. So timer 1 will not be C. All are 0. First 4-bit is for, just see my copy. First 4-bit is for timer 1. So first 4-bit will be 0. Sir, next 4-bit. Sir, get pin not set by the us. Get pin set by the hardware. So it also 0. Sir, C oblique T bar. We are using the timer operation, not counter operation. That's why it should be 0. Sir, which mode? That is a mode 1. Mode 1, what are the value of M1 and M0? This is M1. This is M0. What are the value of M1 and M0? Mode 1, that is a 01. So its value is nothing but a 0. It's nothing but a 1. So that's why, you know, in move T mod, the value is 01H. Move T mod, it's 01H. Move T mod, 01H means timer 0, mode 1 is selected. Timer 1 is mode 0 is selected. In timer 1, mode 0 means it will be count. It will be count from 0000 to FFFF. Means your square wave if you want to reduce this time period, if it is T, if you want to reduce this time period, how it is possible? You should be decrease the delay. you should be decrease the delay. Sir, how it will be decrease the delay? How it's possible, sir? It's possible, you know, with the help of that. Sir, how? Move TL0, has 0F2H. Move TL0, has 0F2H. And move TI0, has FFH. So what are the value of TI0 and TL0? What are the value of TI0 and TL0? It's nothing but a FFF2. It's nothing but a FFF2. I'm talking about TI0 and TL0 is nothing but a FFF2. FFF2, right? So it will be count. So it will be count. FFF2 to FFFF. It will be count from FFF2 to FFFF. Sir, it will be count FFF2 to FFFF means a small delay we are using. Main Ranodeep sir. Main means we are using a smaller time delay. We are using a smaller time delay, right? Smaller time delay means FFF2 to FFFF counting. Sir, if you need a bigger time delay, then you know initial value will be reduced. So this counting time is nothing but a T on. It will be nothing but a T off. So depend upon that, this corresponding T will be generated. So as you know, now we are starting with a program. So I'm just starting with any kind of value, that is the FFF2. Next, I will be telling you that we need just like a 2 kilohertz frequency. We need just like a 4 kilohertz frequency. You are given, you are write the program. Then you should be calculate this value. What will be the value? Then the you know corresponding clock will be 2 kilohertz or 4 kilohertz or something like that. So just see the program. We are given the initial value. So after FFFF, what will be happened? It will be 0000. If I am talking about the mode 2, then it will be after FFFF, it will be FFF2. After FFFF, it will be FFF2. Just see my copy. After FFFF, it will be become 0000H. But if you know, if mode 2, it will be FFFF. After FFFF, it will not be possible because mode 2 is 002FF. I just give an example, nothing else. So after FF, it will be stored the initial value. But here it is not possible because it will be stored, you know, not stored automatically. It should be stored again. So I am checking this counting is over or not. Sir, how it will be checked? We are working with a timer 0. So we are checking TF0 bit. We are checking TF0 bit. You know TF0 bit, you are checking if TF0 bit is 0, means TF0 bit is 0, means counting is going on. If TF0 is equal to 1, means this transaction, means these transactions. Means after FFFF, when it will be become 0000H, it's nothing but a TF flag will be set. That is timer overflow flag will be set. That is the TF0 flag will be automatically set. So I am checking the TF0 flag, whether TF0 flag 1 or not. If TF0 is 0, then you nothing but a counting is going on. TF0 is equal to 1, mean my counting is over. Next part, sir. You know, just coming into the program, CPLP 1.5. What are the functions of CPLP 1.5? Just complement. Before it may be 0, so now it will be 1. Complement P 1.5 is nothing but a, before that it will be 0, so now it will be 1. So CPLP 1.5, it will be 1. A called delay. Delay means jump from this line to that line. Jump from this line to that line because this is nothing but a subroutine. This is nothing but a subroutine, A called delay. Jump from this line to that line. Next, set B TR0. What are the functions of set B TR0? Set B TR0 is nothing but a, just see set B TR0, what are the functions? Say set B TR0 is nothing but a, I already told to you, TRX bit, after set the TRX bit, corresponding timer will be automatically on for counting the clock pulses. That is the function, sir. So TR0 is nothing but a corresponding, you know, timer means timer 0 will be automatically on for counting the clock pulses. Just see my copy, FFFT to FFFF, this counting is started after set BTR0, after set BTR0. Before that, it's not possible. After set BTR0, the counting is started from FFFT, FFF2 to FFFF, from FFF2 to FFFF. Then whenever you know the counting is over, then CLR TR0. What are the functions of CLR TR0? Clear TR0. What are the functions of CLR TR0? Stop the counting. Stop the counting means, sir, first it start the counting. Counting is going on. Checking whether the TF0 is 0 or not. TF0 is 0, then means repeated once again. When TF0 is nothing but is over, counting is over, then coming into the next line, that is the CLR TR0. CLR TR0 means stop the counting. Then CLR TF0, I already told to you that TF0 is set by the hardware but clear by the software. If I am not doing the same thing, that means if I am not clear the TF0, what will be happen? Whenever coming into the next time, this line will not be repeated once again, just coming from this line to that line, because TF0 is set. So checking for the second time, you know, I am clear the TF0. And return from this, where it is call from that line. So return into the next line, that is the S jump here. S jump here means jump from this line to that line. Again, store the initial value. Again, you know, complement the P1.5. Again, the delay. Again, this procedure is going on and going on. This is, you know, this procedure is just continue once again. Then it can be possible. Sir, if any queries in this program, you can ask me. No issue, sir. I will be explain you in a bigger way. For the initial value, first over here, we are storing the timer 0 mode 1 with the help of TMOD 01H. Next, CPLP 1.5 means complement P1.5. A call delay means I'm waiting for a few minutes. Is jump here from this time to this time. What is the delay? A call delay means waiting. How it will be wait is nothing but a set BTR0 means timer will be start from FFF2 to FFFF. Means this line will be repeated until FFFF is over. Whenever FFFF is over, means TF0 flag will be 1. TF0 flag will be 1 means this condition will not be true. As this condition will not be true, coming into the next line, CLR TF0 means, you know, TF0 flag will be again 0. So whenever coming into the next time, this program, this line will we can again this can be checked, and the return means return from the interrupt subroutine. And this nothing but a, you know, with the help of this program, you can generate a square delay program, you know, square wave program in P1.5. No, sir. Next, your very important thing is that some maybe know, but you know, how to delay, you know, delay calculations. For delay calculations, you just see how, you know, the formula. Say, I'm given an initial value. How many count? That's, you know, depend upon that, you know, how, what are the delay? Means calculations, what are the calculations part? Any formula if have, yes, a formula is have, just I'm, you know, elaborate the formula. Say, you have ABCD, you are given the initial value. ABCD. So it will be start ABCD and it will be end at FFFF. So first ABCD, then AB, CE, up to AV, FF. Sir, then it should be AC00, Again, it should be up to AC, FF, next sir, AD, 00, 2. Sir, if you want to say something, you can. Sir, anyone have any queries, you can. You just unmute and you can, sir. Sir, anyone, if you want to say, you raise your hand. So if you want to say something, you can. Maybe unfortunately, it's by mistake. AD00 to ADFF. Next, it will be continue up to FFFF. Next, how many counting will be there? Sir, how many counting will be there? First, forget about it. Forget about it. This portion, first I'm eliminating. From AC0 to ACFF, how much count, sir? 0 to FF. FF means 255. 0 to 255 means it will be 256 count. It will be 256 count. 0 to FF means it will be 256 count. Again, from AD0 to ADFF, it will be 256 count. So every time, you know, AC to AD, AD to AE, every time 256 count. So if I'm talking about count 225, how much count? So you will be count like that, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sir, it is a 4. So on the other hand, I can say like that, 5 minus 2 plus 1. That is 5 minus 2 plus 1. That is 6 minus 2. It is a 4. So from AC to FF, how much count, sir? AC to FF? AC to FF is nothing but a FF minus AC plus 1. AC to FF. AC to FF, how much count? Similar to 2 to 5 count. 2 to 5 count means 2, 3, 4, 5. There is a 4 count. Similarly, AC to FF means, sir, FF minus AC plus 1. So FF minus AC plus 1. So it is nothing but a, FF is nothing but a 255 minus AC plus 1. So if I'm, you know, or for every times, it will be increased one times, means here counting is 256. So total count will be 256. From if I'm talking about these portions, if I'm talking about these portions, that is the counting. FF minus AC plus 1 into 256. FF minus AC plus 1 into 256. Sir, into 256, why? Every time it is 256 count. Sir, next, FF plus 1, what does it mean? FF means 255, plus 1 means 256. So 256 minus AC into 256. Next, sir, what is the AC? What is the AC? We can say AB plus 1 because AB is the initial value. So it is like that. 256 minus THX plus 1 into 256. Sir, why? THX, sir, AB is nothing but a value of THX, CD is value of TLX. So it is the initial value. Just see in this, you know, in my slide, the value of initial is TA is 0. This FFF2, instead of FFF2, I am just calculating ABCD. So AB is nothing but a value of TA is 0. So here I am just talking about, you know, in a copy, my copy is, I am mentioning TA is 0 and TL 0 together is THX. I'm just, you know, given a THX plus 1. So 256 minus THX plus 1 into 256. That is nothing but a functions. So AB to FF, it will be count 256 minus THX plus 1 into 256. That is the total count. Next, sir, I am just eliminating these portions. How much count over here? FF minus CD plus 1. This count is nothing but a FF minus CD plus 1. FF, CD to FF, as 2 to 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4 count means 5 minus 2 plus 1. Similarly, FF minus CD plus 1. So FF plus 1 is nothing but a 256 minus CD. So what is 256 minus CD? You know, so I am just adding this 256 minus CD. Or we can say 256 minus TLX plus 256 minus TLX. That is the formula. You know, for mode 2, for mode 1, we are using this kind of formula. This is the number of machine cycle. So if you need the T state into 12, if you need, you know, time, so by FOSC. That's the difference. Next, sir, if I'm just shown to you the exact formula, so you will just see 256 minus THX plus 1 into 256 plus 256 minus TLX. This is the total formula. As if you know delay time, so into 12, it will be converted into the T state by FOSC, means it will be time. On the other hand, it can be calculated like that. Whatever my example, FFFF minus ABCD plus 1. FFFF minus ABCD plus 1, but you know, it is X2 by X2 decimal conversion is put up, is not very easy. So it can be done in this way, or you can, you know, convert this into the decimal. So FFFF plus 1 is nothing but a 65536. FFFF plus 1 is nothing but a 65536. So 65536 minus this value. Minus this YYXS, whatever the value of ABCD, you are converting into the decimal, you put it over here. And why it is a multiplied by 1 microsecond? It's assuming that is a 12 megahertz crystal. If it is not a 12 megahertz crystal, it is a 11.0592 megahertz, then it will be 1.085 microsecond. Next, these are the things is that. And next day, you know, if I have a time, so I can do. No, I don't have any time. So I cannot do. Next day we'll be discuss how mode 1 and how mode 2 formula will be generated, how mode 1, mode 0 and mode 2 formula will be generated. You can go through by your own. I will be discuss tomorrow how mode 0 and mode 2 formula will be generated like that. Any queries if you have, you can ask. No issue, happy to answer. This is for mode 1 actually. Similarly, mode 0 and mode 2, we have a two different formula will be there. I will be discussed tomorrow. If you have any queries, so I can give the answers.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. And if you don't have any kind of query, so we are end up my this today's sessions. I will be meet with you tomorrow, and come in time. We'll be start in the at that particular time. And discussion is always going on, and be safe. Some faculty members already college is started. It's a big challenge. I don't know how you are handling this kind of situations. I cannot say, but I pray to God that all of you save. Anything else, sir? Thank you. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.